Hello everyone. I was going to talk about the three theorists that Masterson, from his book, The Personality Disorder, talks about in an effort to show how they all build upon one another to bring us to today's contemporary theories on personality disorders. However, there's a couple more important theorists I need to mention. That would be Otto Kernberg briefly, but mostly Heinz Kohut and self-psychology. First, a little bit about Otto Kernberg according to Wikipedia.com. He is a psychoanalyst and professor of psychiatry at Weill Cornell Medical School, and he is most widely known for his psychoanalytic theories on borderline personality organization and narcissistic pathology. In addition, his work has been central in integrating post-war ego psychology with Kleinian and other object relations perspectives. His integrative writings were central to the development of modern object relations theory in psychoanalytic psychology. So, you can see why he needs to be talked about. Next, is Heinz Kohut, who was an Austrian-American psychoanalyst best known for his development of self-psychology, an influential school of thought within psychodynamic, psychoanalytic theory which helped transform the modern practice of analytic and dynamic treatment approaches. While they both tackle the problems of personality disorders, their approaches are differ, as you will soon hear. Now, according to Masterson, attachment theorists suggest that pathological development occurs in the first year of life. Kohut, along with Kernberg, apply their theories to pathological development and not normal development. Then it would follow that pathological development stems from insecure attachment. Kernberg maximizes the role of mother, where he takes the Kleinian perspective of genetic input and constitutional aggression makeup of intrapsychic representations. More recently, Kernberg noted that the most important cause of severe personality disorders is chronic traumatic experiences such as physical or sexual abuse, severe deprivation of love, severe neglect, unavailable parental dispositions that can lead to the development of personality disorders. I think what is important to note here is the use of the word severe, and that he says can lead, versus does lead to. So that's a brief bit about Kernberg's approach. Now, Kohut is the founder of self-psychology. His role of mother lies in defective mirroring. This would be when the mother lacks empathy for the child's grandiose exhibitionistic self. This is where the mother is unable to respond to the child for a variety of possible reasons, none of which have to do with the child. Kohut breaks from Freud theories of oral and phallic needs to say the child breaks away for separation and individuation needs. Here, Kohut was the first to emphasize the clinical manifestations of the grandiose representations in the N.P.D./ and the real difficulties of self-activation. In the 1950s, Kohut introduced the concept of self-object, by the way, that is one word, and does not use a hyphen, at the heart of self-psychology, and then in the therapies for personality disorders. To give you a better idea of self-psychology, I'll define some terms often used. 1. Mirror self-object. This is where the therapist reflects back to the client and praises him or her like a mother would. 2. Ideal self-object, or the idealized father. This is where the client would idealize the therapist. 3. Twinship self-object, where the therapist and client see eye to eye. 4. Adversarial self-object, this would be when client and therapist are constantly bumping up against one another. However, where self-definition is promotional, there is acceptance. 5. Abstract self-object. Here is a belief that God, posterity, or past relationships sustain self-esteem. Kohut also went on to introduce disintegration of self-object, which leads to emptiness, self-aggression, addictions, and depression. So, in self-psychology, one would use sustained empathetic inquiry and look at patterns from the patient's perspective, even if the patient is psychotic. After all, it is their perspective. Key in therapy is the disruption repair cycle, and this is a point when the patient feels understood where transmuting internalization takes place. When the patient has enough empathy for himself, he or she is able to build his own self-object. The key difference between Kernberg and Coit lies in Kernberg's belief that the narcissist is suffering from conflict, not deficit. Narcissism is seen as a manic defense, so Coit would identify when the patient becomes depressed in an effort to disrupt then repair the cycle. In an article by Paul Thagard, PhD, called "What is the Self?" he says we are a complex system operating at four different levels: molecular, neural, physiological, and social. Furthermore, genetics and epigenetics, neurotransmitters and hormones, are increasingly important in explaining the differing aspects of personalities, as well as social interactions that greatly impact our self-concepts. Basically, you can't be yourself by yourself, and the self is a multi-level system. Moreover, we can't directly observe the self. It is a theoretical entity that can only be hypothesized in order to explain an enormous array of important psychological phenomena. That said, getting more into the topic of self-psychology and how it operates. Coit was a staunchly conservative analyst who later broke away with his own psychology, called self-psychology. As I've said earlier, the concept is all about empathetic listening, solely to understand and entertain the patient's perspective. With this, he coined the term experience near. This is where the patient's perspective is all that matters, again even if they're psychotic. And the sequence of disruption and reparation of empathetic connectedness between the analyst and patient is inevitable and effective in treatment. The level of empathy would ideally be kept at an optimal level, and of course this would be an essential ingredient in the development of the psyche and analytic cure. So, in this experience near empathetic perspective lies Coit's understanding of the patient's borderline, or narcissist, need for recognition as an arrest in development due to empathetic failures of childhood, which he later theorized to be a mirror self-object transference. Author, Dr. Craig Malkin, in his book, Rethinking Narcissism, briefly explains Coit's break from Freud. Whereas Freud placed too much emphasis on sex and aggression as the center of human experience, Coit argued rather, it's our need to develop a solid sense of self. Therefore, we don't just need people, we need narcissism. Where Freud saw self-reliance as a virtue, autonomous adults demanding neither approval or admiration, and narcissism as a mark of immaturity and an infantile dependency to be outgrown. Alternatively, Coit saw narcissism as vital to well-being throughout life. He viewed narcissism in a benevolent light, whereas Kernberg saw narcissism as inherently dangerous and harmful. Well, that's a bit to be taken in. What do you think? Is Freud right? Is narcissism something to be outgrown, or is Coit right? We all have narcissism, so embrace it as an important part of our personality. Or is the self so multi-layered that we can hardly begin to grasp its complexity, and is it something we can never truly know? Hopefully, next time I will be building up to Masterson's theories of personality disorders, and how he diagnoses and treats borderline, narcissists, and schizoid personalities. Remember to like and subscribe and follow me on Facebook and Instagram, as well as start or add to a discussion below. Here's hoping you're enjoying peace of mind living narcissist free. Love to all.